Okay, we continue, and we're going to talk to a very interesting man who was on the program a long time ago. It's been many, many years, and Lieutenant Colonel Dave Grossman is still at it, and what that is trying to help Americans understand how to protect themselves. And if you have ever called 9/11 and had them take a long time to get there, like real long, like too long, and maybe sometimes they don't call at all, you just are left sitting there wondering what's going on. They don't have to answer those calls, by the way, just so you know. There's no law on the books. They just do their best. But empowering our citizens to stop future horrors like Virginia Tech and Columbine is critical. You folks literally have to become our, well, DV Kid and others have called them the real militia, the citizen militia. You've got to learn to protect yourselves, and that's what Dave Grossman has been trying to do for a long, long time. He's got some new materials out. We're going to talk about that. He is world-renowned and is the founder of the USCCA, and he is with us tonight. Are you there, Dave?
Yeah, good to talk to you, Jeff. It's been a long time.
It has. It seems like, I don't know how long, but it sounds like you've been busy. And let me just ask you this.
Yeah.
Have you been making a lot of progress in helping people not only become armed, but learn how to properly use those arms?
Yeah.
And we had so many firearms sold for Christmas. That encouraged me. And I tell my listeners, folks, even if you don't like guns, go get your concealed weapons permit if your state or area allows it, just to let the government know you care about the Constitution and the Second Amendment. Just
Amen.
Get the damn permit.
Amen. Jeff, you used the right word earlier. You talked about empowering our citizens. I love our nation. The thing I love most is our freedom, and the greatest freedom is the right to keep bear arms.
Sure is.
Around the world, cops are not allowed to carry their gun off duty. Canada, across Europe. And we've got a model that we can draw from. The thing that I think should be in our minds first and foremost, other than our domestic threat, which is significant, is the potential for an external threat. My audio video series being published by USCCA, U.S. Concealed Carry Association, is the Bulletproof Mind. And we got that linked on Wrench.com.
You bet.
That's great. I love it when you've got like a one-stop shopping center there. But the Bulletproof Mind for Armed Citizens, and we talk about the threat, and we recommend a series of books. I train all of the feds. I train all federal agencies. I train all of our spec ops, all our tier one. Spec ops. I train cops in all 50 states. I train school safety across a big chunk of America. And one of the things we know is there is a great danger to our schools, internal, external. There aren't enough cops. There aren't enough soldiers to put one person on every school bus in America. There are not enough soldiers. There are not enough cops to put an armed responder in every single school and middle school in America. The answer becomes the Swiss model in which we empower our citizens. Switzerland, one of the most armed nations on the planet. Every single adult male citizen in Switzerland, member of the militia, has a military rifle ammo in their houses. They have many guns beside that. Switzerland, one of the most armed nations on the planet, has one of the lowest crime rates in Europe. England, who's been trying to confiscate guns for 50 years, has one of the highest crime rates in Europe. That Swiss model, the only possible answer is to empower our citizens. Texas is leading the way with armed educators across Texas. Abilene, Texas, the largest city in Texas so far, but hundreds of school districts across Texas. Across Utah, I work with individual sheriffs. And county by county, the sheriffs are calling the shots. And across Utah, we have armed educators, armed school bus drivers. We trust that school bus driver with their kids' life. One twitch of the wheel, he could kill every kid on that school bus.
That's
Once
true.
Once he's been properly trained and certified, we test him. We trust him to protect our kids from violence.
Right.
That's really what the Constitution was all about, was to empower individual citizens to face this kind of threat.
You can buy all the guns you want, but if you actually don't get out and learn how to use them, it's not going to help you. In a panic situation,
Bulletproof Mind is all about.
That's right.
It's not just having the gun. It's being trained and mentally prepared, A, to use an act of violence when it's needed, and B, to live with it afterwards. Bulletproof
okay.
Mind, mental preparation.
GetBulletproofMind.com.
That's it.
GetBulletproofMind.com. You have only a second or two or three sometimes in these situations to decide upon a course of action which could end up saving your life and maybe the lives of many others around you. There are a lot of people out there who are mentally not well, and there are God only knows how many guns in this country. That's good, because guns on balance every year thwart, I don't know, what are the statistics,
it's
Dave? How many crimes?
The vast majority of the thwarted crimes never get reported.
True.
We have thousands and thousands, potentially tens and hundreds of thousands of crimes thwarted every year.
And no one has to shoot. They actually do not discharge the weapon, but they have it, and they pull it out, and the criminal will back away and run. That's what happens.
And nobody ever hears about it.
Never.
The greatest achievement is the crime that didn't happen.